guide was Mr. Ramesh Kumar Singh, and his topic of PhD was characterization and modeling of pyrolytic carbon micro machining for creation of engineered features. So this was the micro machining topic, which is the PhD topic of Professor Bajpayee. And his experience, if we talk about the experience, he was also in Mahindra Ecole Center Hyderabad, which is a very reputed autonomous body, and he was in the School of Engineering from for almost 1 year he was there, and then he got selected for the IIT ISM Dhanbad, and he has done his postdoctoral again from the Ulsan National Institute of Technology and Science, Ulsan, South Korea, from the Department of Mechanical Engineering. It was a 1 year postdoctoral, and he is having a lot of publication, and the list of his publication is endless. More than 70, 80 publications in the international and the reputed SCI journals he has completed. At present, he is guiding about how many PhD candidates? About 11 or 10.
10, total 10.
10, 10. He is guiding 10 odd PhD candidates, and he's working on electrical discharge machining. He has completed a project on the micro machining center with cryo-cooled attachment in the function. This is what he has done. And he's in charge of the this cryo-cooled vertical machining center, and electrical discharge machining also he's working with, and these are the expertization. This very new topic he has taken up to speak on for the undergraduate and the postgraduate students of this area. It is a pretty new topic, and I hope the students and the faculty and rest of the all participant will enjoy him. Fortunately, I happen to be his teacher from Rewa Engineering College. He has done his graduation from Government Engineering College, Rewa, in 96, and and now I hand over this mic to Professor Vivek Bajpayee. Professor Bajpayee will speak out now and start his presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor. He has mentioned the thing at the last, which I have done my starting research at GC Rewa under Professor Asim Tiwari. And this is his graduate, so that I'm here. I'm very thankful to him. And I'm always thankful to him. So I'm starting my topic. This is cryogenic machining of titanium-64 alloy. First of all, we have to think what is cryogenic, and then machining, and the third one is titanium-64. All three have their own importance. Machining, we all know. Machining, if you see the picture, the bottom picture in the screen, this is the simplest form of orthogonal machining. The issue with the machining is, which we have addressed here, if we do machining on conventional materials like on mild steel, like aluminum, etc., a little softer materials, you can cut easily. The leg, the workpiece, as a hard material like titanium alloy or nickel alloy, so you have to choose a tool much, much harder than the workpiece materials. Sometimes we apply coating, a hard coating of thickness about 4 to 5 micrometer. You can see in this figure, blue color is a coating over the tool. So this coating is applied over the tool to protect the tool from extra heat. What the extra heat can do? It can damage the tool. It can damage the tool. So this coating can protect the tool. Second thing, due to high heat, especially if we see the title, the material is titanium-64. Its property is low thermal conductivity. Low thermal conductivity means it is generating high heat due to high hardness, but due to low thermal conductivity, the heat is accumulating at the area where it is generated. So in the orthogonal machining, you can say the primary deformation zone is the main source of heat. This main source of heat generates a lot of heat, which goes to the rake face of the tool. Due to this heat, the hardened tool becomes softer and high wear rate occurs, which is highly undesirable. Titanium 64 is an important material. It is used in aerospace and medical implants. It means machining is again important. It is not just a conventional MS or aluminium to cut by any tool like high speed steel. So we use tungsten carbide as a tool. Tungsten carbide is again a very costly material. Coating is again a costly material. Workpiece is itself a very costly material. So how to cool? Question is how to cool. So if you see in thermodynamic point of view, we have a body. The body is at high temperature. Our objective is to take heat from that temperature. We can apply fluid cooling. So the properties to the coolant should be, its specific heat capacity should be very high. What we can do, we can add nanoparticles like CNT, MOS2, etc. to increase the specific heat of the coolant. The second method is we can increase the delta T. It means the temperature of the heat zone and the temperature of the coolant. So temperature of heat zone is not in our hand. It is already very high. If we use a coolant at room temperature, first option. Second option, if we use a coolant much, much lower than the room temperature, that is at cryogenic temperature, we can increase delta T significantly high so that the heat removal will tremendously high. So the cryogenic means we are applying a coolant at a cryogenic temperature, which will remove the heat from the cutting zone. By removing the heat from the cutting zone, we can control the cutting zone temperature, which will help in improving the tool life. An improved tool life will give you the better surface finish and low cost in machining or product development. So we'll start what we have done. So the second question is, suppose I have given you this solution, use some cryogenic kind of thing and it will reduce the heat and the tool life will be this much higher. If you go to industry and I will ask, use cryogenic, will they accept it? They will say, no, our machine is about 10 to 20 crore rupees and you are adding another 1 crore rupees in the system. And what is the guarantee? So what is the method of guarantee is, we do not impose everything in one lot. What we do small experiments that are called pilot experiments. So during pilot experiments, we do experiment in small scale, apply cryogenic liquid, in our case it is liquid nitrogen, with different volume, with different methods, and see the response. So there are two things. First thing is application of cryogenic liquid into the cutting zone, and method of application means fluid cooling, dip the workpiece and tool in the cryogenic liquid, which is very expensive and the handling is very, very difficult. Second, use a nozzle and put the cryogenic liquid in the cutting zone. The process response are, our objective is to increase the tool life as well as surface roughness. So what you can see, we can machine without cryogenic cooling once with different process parameters. Process parameters means depth of cut, in changing the undercut chip area, or increasing the cutting speed, increasing tool geometry, changing tool geometry like changing rake angle, relief angle, etc. So there are two comparisons. First is dry machining. We will see what is the tool like. Second is we will apply the coolant to the cutting zone. Coolant means cryogenic coolant, and we'll see the tool life. If we see that about 2 to 3 repetitions. Repetitions are very important in experiments. So in 2 to 3 repetitions, if we see that the tool life is increasing tremendously, about 20-30%, 20-30% sufficient. then we can say that this method is feasible. Now we can go for mass scale. So in the cryogenic machining, we have done experimental work. I am just reading outlines. Motivation, which I was delivering, why we need that. Specific objectives, experimental work, how we have created the experimental setup, result discussion, and a little discussion about future development. So now we are starting the tool life improvement in cryogenic machining of titanium 64. This is the specific title. It was supported by Samsung Electronics South Korea. Titanium, its mechanical properties are high strength at high temperature. It means if you use this in space shuttles during their evacuation or in any condition, if the temperature is very high, the material will not lose its strength. High strength to weight ratio means it is very lightweight and excellent biocompatibility. You can put the material inside the human body and it will behave like a human material. The system of the human will not respond. Applications are turbine blades, you can see the picture, medical implants, and aviation space. So they are called motivation. It means if you are performing some job, why are you performing? This is the question, why are you performing this job? Is it important? Yes, it is important because of the mechanical properties of the material and its application in cutting edge technology. The motivation is done. It means we can perform the job. Now, what are the problems? Problems with the material is poor machinability. Why? Due to the lower thermal conductivity, increase in temperature stress along the cutting edges, burr formation. Burr may be a new word for you. So the picture is here. The paper is published in 2012. You can see a slot was made by a milling operation, micro milling operation in IIT Bombay. You can see there are unwanted chips which are attached with the workpiece. These are called burrs, which are highly unwanted. And if you are doing micro machining, you can see the scale here. Scale is 100 micrometers. So the total width of the channel is about 500 micrometers. It is called micro machining. In micro machining, the burr size is again very small. If you compare with the scale, the burr size is about 100 to 200 micrometers. Your hair diameter is about 60 to 70 diameter. So you can assume the burr size is very small, but in comparison with the feature, it is about 20 to 30%. So removal of small burrs is very, very difficult. Built up edge means a material stick with the cutting edge of the tool, which will make it thicker and the cutting forces will be very high. These are the different problems associated with machining of titanium alloy. The last of problem is high rate of tool wear, which we have addressed in our experimental work and in our presentation. How to tackle the problem of high rate of tool wear in machining of titanium alloy. So before going to the machining, with the help of cryogenic and the dry machining, it is required to go for some literature survey. Literature survey means different journals published in the past, what they are saying. What they are saying is, in orthogonal machining, there are two locations. First is rake face, which I have shown in the first figure. The heat is generating from there. Second is flank face. So three modes can be applied. First is apply the cryogenic coolant from the rake face. Second, apply the cryogenic coolant from the flank face. And third one is apply the cryogenic studying different literatures. We have found that the cutting temperature first, tool wear and tool life have been analyzed, and it is observed that if we compare dry cutting, emulsion, flank, rake and rake plus flank. So these are three are our objectives. The cutting temperature was in dry cutting, it was 865 degrees centigrade, which is reduced to 208 degrees centigrade if you apply rake face and flank face cryogenic together. So you can see it is about four times lower. In the dry machining, it was 865. Aluminum will melt in this temperature. And while applying coolant from two places, rake face and flank face, it is 208 degrees centigrade. If you see this data, you can assume without looking the other columns, tool wear and tool life, don't look that columns. Just look at here. In one condition, dry machining, it was 865 degrees centigrade. In rake plus flank, it is 208 degrees centigrade. Very, very less cutting joint temperature. In this situation, it will increase the tool life and it will decrease the tool wear. So look at the second column. The tool wear was 0.026 inch in dry cutting and 0.04 inch in rake and flank. If the temperature is decreasing, the tool wear is decreasing. It means the tool life will increase. So in rake flank, rake plus flank configuration is 948 second, while in dry cutting it was 167 second. So the cutting temperature is the measured quantity. Tool wear and tool life are acquired from the cutting temperature. So this proved that our direction of the experiment or our direction of the research is going in the correct direction. So what is new we are doing? The question is novelty. Everything has been done. Rake face coolant has been done. Flank face coolant has been done. Rake and plus flank is done. A comparison with dry and emulsion cooling has been done. What we are doing? If everything is done. So requirement of novelty. We have to do something new. So other than the previously done job, we will do milling operation. What is the new in milling operation? If you see a milling operation, and suppose it has two flutes, it is a rotating kind of tool. One tool is cutting and one tool is not cutting for half of its rotation. It means other than orthogonal machining, what was the case of orthogonal machining? The chip was in the contact of rake face in a regular manner. In milling operation, the chip comes in contact with the cutting fluid for half of its rotation and half of the rotation is it is free. If you are taking the axial depth of cut is equal to diameter of the tool. It means we have about 50% time when the tool is freely. We have taken. And the advantage is if the tool is not cutting, dry machining, which is for the comparison, cryogenic assisted machining. Now the question is why we have done the third option. Third option means cryogenic machining with preheated workpiece. So during all the analysis of the literature and the experiment, during experiment, a problem has been occurred. The problem was as the cryogenic liquid was applied to the cutting zone, it was applied to the tool as well as it was applied to the workpiece and it was reducing the temperature of the workpiece. What will be done? The hardness of the titanium alloy was increased due to the decrease in the temperature, which is unwanted. Our idea was to put the cryogenic liquid into the cutting zone. But what happened? Due to the very low temperature, handling of cryogenic fluid is difficult. So excess amount was fall into the workpiece and it has increased the hardness of the job. This increased hardness has increased the cutting forces. So in addition of the high cutting zone temperature, another thing has been added, which is the hardness of the workpiece. It is increased due to the cryogenic liquid. It is a side effect. It has increased the cutting forces and which is highly undesirable. We need low cutting forces. The third option has been implemented. A heater was fit just below the workpiece and it was heating to the job. So first condition, without heater. Second condition, heater is 100 degrees centigrade, a constant temperature. And third condition is heater is 200 degrees centigrade. Have been used. values. So material removal volume was calculated. Second thing is material removal volume. Why? The volume of the material removed by the tool before it wear out. That is, we have taken the wear was measured. It was measured by the flank wear. Move to the next. The experimental setup has been developed. Here you can see a milling tool. It is the spindle. The tool is fitted in the spindle. Here it is the heater, rod heater, rod electric heaters. The job. This white one is the nozzle for providing liquid nitrogen. So in the machine tool, three axis in any experiment, it is very important to mention which machine tool you have used. If you don't want to use the make and model to remove the promotion of a particular make and model, you can put the key specification. It was a three-axis vertical milling machine in which the spindle can rotate up to a maximum spindle rotation of 10,000 RPM and its accuracy is 10 micrometer. It is not a micro machine. Tool was SICWC coated, 3 millimeter diameter, 30 degree was the helix angle, and number of floats is 2. Workpiece is titanium 64 or TI6AL4V grade 5. It is in general it is known as grade 5 titanium. Why we are mentioning everything? It means if someone wants to repeat the experiment, he can simply repeat. Therefore, we are explaining everything, which machine tool was taken, what was the tool geometry, tool material, SIC coated, WC the base material, what was the workpiece, the size of the workpiece about 2 by 2 inch. And it is about 10 mm thick. Chemical composition and general mechanical composition of the material. This is not our findings. This is a general term available in literature. So before machining, you have to see the chemical composition of any material. Because during machining, if the workpiece material and the tool material or the coating of the tool, if they have some kind of chemical affiliation. So other than machining, a chemical reaction will start. So we mention the chemical composition of the workpiece each time. Now move to the next point. All this drawing has been prepared in Creo. So the first drawing is made and then physical object was made. So bar electric heater, two numbers about 100 watt, 220 volt. These are all the specifications and location just below the workpiece in a copper plate through a hole. The experimental condition, how the experiments have been performed. In the table, label 0, 1, 2, cutting condition, one is dry for the comparison process, comparison purpose. Second is lin, lin means liquid nitrogen. The second one is liquid nitrogen plus heater. Cutting speed, two cutting speeds, 25 meter per minute and 50 meter per minute have been taken, and 137 has been taken in between. The full factorial experiment has been performed. Cutting speed has high influence because the cutting speed decided the heat dissipation during the machining operation. So tool diameter, it is not 300 micrometer, it's 3 millimeter. By mistake, it is 300 micrometer, it is 3 millimeter. And everything has already been decided. Depth of cut, 100 micrometer, feet 50 micrometer per tooth per revolution. And 6 loops have been done. AR means radial depth of cut is about D by 2 inch, means diameter divided by 2, means 1.5 millimeter. In this picture, you can see the schematic of the experimental work. So how to measure the temperature? So in the literature survey, we have seen that if the temperature is decreasing, it means the tool life is increasing. Means temperature measurement is the key feature. How to measure that? It is a thermal camera has been used in dry machining, in liquid nitrogen, and in liquid nitrogen plus heater. It is visible that the temperature of the liquid nitrogen is the least. That means least. In the dry, it is very high. We can move to the next slide. One thing which I have not mentioned here, which is a force nanometer, because two things are important. First is temperature of the cutting zone, second, cutting forces, and third is tool wear. The temperature has been measured with the help of thermocouples as well as thermal camera. Cutting forces have been measured by Kistler dynamometer. A Kistler dynamometer is a piezoelectric based dynamometer which can measure the forces in three directions, X, Y, Z. The beauty of the machine is, over the other strain gauge type of dynamometer, is its frequency is very high. In 1 second, you can take about 1 or 10 lakhs of readings. So due to high sampling frequency, we use Kistler dynamometer in milling operation. The cost is very high. The cheapest Kistler dynamometer is 35 lakhs. Cheapest means the lowest cost. So this is the result of material removal rate. Start from the figure A. The vertical y-axis is tool wear and the horizontal is cutting time in all the figures, in all three figures. So you can see there are three lines and the presentation is, this one is dry, the blue one is dry, red one is liquid nitrogen and the green one is liquid nitrogen plus heater. Now look at the first plot. The cutting speed was 25 meter per minute. Look at the blue one. It has starting from 100 micrometer at a time about 10 minutes. After 10 minute machining, the material, the tool wear was 100 micrometer. You can see different points. It means in each 10 minute, the reading was taken. And here you can see the tool wear reaches at a level of 300. In general, if the flank wear is 300 micrometers, it is considered that the tool is weared out. Now this is the red one. You see, the 10 minute readings have been taken in the red one, that is the liquid nitrogen, and it has taken about 50 minutes for reaching at 300 micrometer. So if you compare both the lines, the first line, dry machining, it has reached about in 30 minutes, the second again 50 minutes. Now the third condition, applied liquid nitrogen. In liquid nitrogen plus heater, it means that workpiece is in lower temperature. It has reached to the value of 300 micrometer at about 70 minutes. So the first case, dry machining 30, liquid nitrogen 50 approximate, and the liquid nitrogen plus heater 70 minutes. So if we compare, dry is the base. From the dry machining, the life is increased by about 44% if we use only liquid nitrogen. If we use liquid nitrogen plus heater, the tool life is increased by 78 micrometer. Sorry, 78%. So based on this experiment, we can say that using liquid nitrogen will increase the tool life. Now you can see the vertical black lines, this one. Here you can see, everywhere you can see black, vertical black lines. These are called error bars. Error bar means the experiment was not done only once. It is repeated about 2 to 3 times, and every time the reading was under the value of that vertical lines. It means the level of confidence is very high. If you are doing one experiment, it is giving some reading. Next day, repeat the experiment. If you are getting the reading approximately same, it means the experiment was correct. Because it is impossible to predict any experimental result with a single repetition, with a single experiment. So repetition is very important. Now move to the second figure. The difference between both the figures is it was at 25 meter per minute and it is 37.5 meter per minute. Now In the previous case, it was 44%. In this case, it is 46%. Because the values are approximately same. 44 and 46 are not much different. Here it is 88. So 78 become 88. In the third case, if the cutting speed is increased by 50 meters per minute, the increased tool life is 47% and 76%. From all three figures, we can conclude that cryogenic is increasing the tool life by about 50%. We can say 47, 46 are approximate 50%. And if you use heating plus cryogenic, it can increase the tool life up to 80%. In the last fourth figure, the same thing has been mentioned in other form, 44, 46, 47. And here the tool life in dry machining are same in all the cutting speeds. Tool life is approximate same in all the cutting speed if we are using liquid nitrogen, and it is increased highly in case of 37.5 meter per minute. It means the experiments are highly confident that this value will be repeated if we implement this system in any industry. In the previous slide, I was saying about the cutting forces, how the cutting forces have been measured. It was the Kistler dynamometer, a piezoelectric based dynamometer. Now the figure, start from the first figure. Three forces are there, FT, FR, and FA. If you have seen milling operation, so in a milling operation, in a end milling operation especially, there are three kinds of forces. Axial force, which is applied along the axis of the cutting tool. The radial force, the tangential and radial forces are normal to each other. And tangential is the normal to the radial, which is tangential to the rotational speed, rotational velocity of the fluid. Which is most important, or which is most dangerous, we can say. Axial force. If you have a tool applying axial force, it is highly strong. You cannot crush a tool. A milling tool cannot be crushed in a thrust direction. In general, milling tool may break with the effect of tangential force or radial force. So which is high, radial or tangential? Radial and tangential forces are like feed and cutting force in a turning or in orthogonal operation. Which is higher? The cutting force is higher. Cutting force is higher means the tangential force, the red one. You can see this red one is very high. So in the axis, you can see we have two vertical axes, left and right. For one figure, we have two vertical axes. Here you can see tangential force in Newton. It is up to 35. In the right hand side, you can see radial and axial forces up to 7 Newton. So if you ignore the radial and axial force, this FR and FA, the FT is very high. What is the highest value of FT? You see this point is corresponds to about 32 Newton. Whereas the radial force is, the maximum radial force is 5 Newton and axial force is 5.5 Newton. So in general, first of all, axial force cannot damage the tool. Ignore that, the green one. We will consider only tangential force, which is most dangerous. Increase the depth of cut by 50 micrometer, 100 micrometer, and 200 micrometer. So the uncut chip area is the combination of depth of cut in the vertical direction and feed per tooth. Multiply both, you will get an area which is called uncut chip area, which is responsible for the material removal. So in this case, if we increase the depth of cut, the forces will increase. Definitely it will increase. So at 50, 100, 200, we are doubling the depth of cut. It is increasing. It is by 48% or 129%. In the second case, the second figure, you can see 50, 100 and 200. We are doubling the feed rate at constant depth of cut. Again, you can see the tangential forces are very high, about 24 Newton. you can ignore the radial and axial force. Here, cutting speed. Cutting speed does not have any significant effect. 17% or 1%. In radial force, it's 35%, but radial force cannot break the tool. So you can ignore that. The main change in the tangential force while changing the cutting speed from 25 to 50 has only 1%. 1% can be neglected. So what is the conclusion from this analysis? The conclusion is tangential force is the main cutting force, which I was explaining. Maximum tangential force is 33 nanometer in this case at highest depth of 200 micrometer. Maximum tangential force is 24 Newton at highest speed here, and 27% less cutting force at equal uncut chip area. It means if you are taking 200 micrometer per float or you are taking 200 micrometer depth, the cutting force is about 27% lesser. It means it is advised to increase the feed in place the depth of cut. What are the specific conclusion? So specific conclusion from all this experiment. Cryogenic machining increases tool life by 47%, which has been shown by the plot. And if we apply heated workpiece, it means reduction in the class salary. So preheated workpiece can increase the tool life by 88%, and material removal volume per tool is directly proportional to the tool life. What are the other issues which are unattended? Coolant, which was cooling the workpiece. So cooling is not controlled in our case because of handling difficulty of cryofluid. Heating of workpiece involves cost. It means if we control the flow of the cryogenic liquid, we can remove the heating job of the workpiece, and that will reduce the cost. So the ultimate job is to reduce the cost of the process. These are a few future scopes on the same process. We can design a smart flow control system. It means it will help in the reduction of liquid nitrogen, which will help in reduction in the machining cost, which is the ultimate goal. Removal of unwanted workpiece cooling, lowering workpiece strength. Hybrid machining system is heating the workpiece as well as cooling. So it means cooling from the backside and heating from the front side, and coolant through tool. Everything is explained by the picture. This is called hybrid machining. If you have a milling operation, we can apply coolant from the backside. In the lower figure, you can see all these floats are cutting or in the cutting process, and all these floats in the backside are in idle condition. So apply cooling from the backside, so they will be exposed for the cooling, and high cooling will be done. Heating will be done from the front side, which will heat the workpiece. You can see the temperature contours. The only problem is in half cycle the tool is under heat, and in half cycle it is under cooling. So the cycle heating cooling may damage the tool. It is still under the experiment process. This is the high speed machine and developed at ITS in Dhanbad. Here we have, it is not shown here, but everything liquid nitrogen system has been developed and fit with this system. And each experiment can be done here. Actually, it is open to all. You can go to the link and you can simply apply for the application. And it is also registered in ISTM website of the central government. So everyone can join and take the services of high-speed machining. This is the method for cooling through the tool. Actually, it is a micro tool. And in general, the diameter of the flank of the micro tool is 3 millimeter. It is a standard. And the cutting diameter is about 100 micron, 50 micron, or 300 micron. What can be done? A hole can be done, and a spline kind of copper material can insert inside the axis in the axis of the tool. While it is rotating, if it is rotating at high speed, these are the holes. This sponge can suck the coolant, and the coolant can go directly to the cutting zone. In this, it is clearly visible. Why we cannot go through this case in this area? Because it is very thin, about 100 micron. So how can you hold below 10 micron, 20 micron? It is possible with the help of laser, but it will weaken the tool because there is a cut, there is a chisel edge which provides the strength of a drilling bit. And if you make a hole in a chisel edge, it will be very, very weakened, and therefore its reliability will be very less. So reached up to the shank only in case of micro milling. These holes have been extended up to the cutting edge. It is now it is used in the industries. The other future scope is fire arm components. I am not explaining so much. It is under review in some project. Thank you, and the forum is open for question and answer.
Thank you very much. It was very informative and knowledge giving to everybody. On behalf of everybody in the mechanical fraternity, I extend you thanks, and hope the students have and the student and faculty, everybody has have taken some concept out of the lecture and benefited out of it. Now the forum is open for the questions. You can unmute and you can ask the question. If anybody is interested in the queries, then the queries can be raised. Like anybody, TechCube team can unmute them. Anybody?
Shantaraji has raised his hand.
Acha, acha. Who is that? Acha.
Full name is not given. Vasundhara DHU.
Vasundhara, yeah. Asked to unmute. Aap unmute kar lijiye, Vasundhara ji. Yeah, इनको unmute करिए वसुंधरा जी को. TechCube team, please unmute Miss Vasundhara Dhruve. You खुद अपन हाँ ठीक है.
Yes sir.
Yeah, आपने question raise करने के लिए hand raise किया था. आप पूछ लीजिए, आपको कुछ पूछना हो तो.
No sir, I mistake हो गया था वो.
No issue, lower hand. ठीक है. Yes, sir. Anybody else is interested in asking the question, then. No one? Okay, then I formally thank again to Vivek, and thank you very much, Vivek, for joining us. Shushank wants to ask something. Shushank, unmute kariye, Shushank. Yeah. शाम कुछ
पूछना सर, ये फेरस मटेरियल के लिए यूज होगी क्या सर? क्रायोजेनिक
का ऑब्जेक्टिव कूलिंग है. मटेरियल कोई भी, यू कैन यूज एनी मटेरियल.
ओके,
टाइटेनियम इज नॉट ए फेरस मटेरियल.
यस सर, आई नो.
इट इज ए कूलिंग टेक्नोलॉजी, हाई ग्रेडियंट कूलिंग टेक्नोलॉजी. You can use for cutting anything.
Sir, तो material structure में तो काफी effect पड़ेगा sir.
Which material structure? Microstructure level.
No sir, in the I think just work piece sir. जैसे कोई भी work piece ले लें sir, उसमें microstructure, उसमें material स्ट्रक्चर तो उसके चेंज हो जाएंगे सर अगर क्रायोजेनिक्स यूज करेंगे तो?
हो सकते हैं, डिपेंड करता है साइकिल कैसी, कूलिंग साइकिल कैसी, उस पर डिपेंड करता है।
ओके आई फार्मली थैंक, ठीक है, थैंक यू। ओके आई फार्मली थैंक प्रोफेसर विवेक वाजपेयी एंड आई आस्क हिम, आई रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू कीप ऑन ज्वाइनिंग अस टाइम टू टाइम एंड दैट विल बी वेरी नाइस टू सी ही यू सी हिम आफ्टर सो मेनी इयर्स and probably I am seeing him after 96 and this is like the storm of memories coming from all the past, and thank you very much, and we stop here, thank you very much.